Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and today we are going to talk about how to use the Morph Transition along with Freeform Shape to create these kind of animations having the curves and the waves into the characters. As you can see in the legs and the hands movement along with the dumbbells. So let's get started, and first of all I would like to show you the design. And whenever you want to inspect someone's presentation, then the best way is go to the home tab, then click the select drop down button and open the selection pane to see that how the shapes or objects has been placed on the presentation. And also if you press the control A key to select all the shapes, or you can also go to the home tab and then click select drop down button and then choose select all to select all the shapes on the slide. And then you can move to the shape format and click the shape fill drop down menu and choose no fill, and later go to shape outline and fill any of the color to see the outline view of the character. And that way you will also get to know the hidden objects which are not visible when the shape is filled with the colors. Like here you can see that we have also placed these two ovals on top of the eye, and we also named all the shapes to later identify them easily. And you can rename the shapes by just clicking the shape name in the selection pane one more time. So let me show you that how I have make a curve in the animation. Because if you go to the animations tab after selecting a shape and then click add animation, then you are not going to find any kind of the animation that may add a curve or a bend to the shape. So how I really did that, let me show you on a new slide. So let's say I wanted to draw a freeform shape, and you can do this from the insert tab, then click shapes drop down button and choose freeform shape. And you can use the freeform shape in two ways. If you click the left mouse button and hold down the button, then it will start drawing like a pencil. And if you release the left mouse button, then it is not going to leave you, it will continue unless you double click. So that is the way if you want to draw something like a pen. So the second method to use the freeform shape is you don't need to click and hold down the left mouse button. Instead, just click the left mouse button once and then move to the point where you want to add the another node. Then again click the left mouse button and then move to the next point where you want to add the next node. And if you don't want to add further nodes, just double click to stop the editing. So let's say if I select this shape now, and the most powerful tool in the shape format is edit shape, edit point. If you want to modify the points of the freeform shape, or you can also modify any of the auto shapes that are available in this list. Let's say if I draw this arrow shape here, then I can also edit the points of this auto shape as well by clicking on edit shape from the shape format and then choose edit points. And then you can easily manipulate the nodes, any of the nodes, and you can also add a new node if you want to by right clicking on the border of the shape carefully and then choose add point. And later you can move the points as you like. And when you select a point, then you can notice that we also have now two more new handles in the white color. So if you want to add a curve between the points, then you can hold down these white pointers and then can start dragging according to the curve you want to add into your shape, like this. So the same way, let me delete these shapes So we now have this shape here, and it is a good idea to name these shapes from the selection pane. Let's say I name it left leg and hit the enter key. You can also hide temporarily if any of the shapes you don't want to see for the time, then you can click on this I button again to hide the shapes. So once you have drawn a shape that you want to manipulate, or the complete character, so I have created the complete character first, then I started manipulating the same character on the next slide by duplicating the slide. Like, you can duplicate any of the slide by right clicking on the slide in the thumbnail pane and then choose duplicate slide, and that is the best way, because the naming consistency is must if you want to use the morph transition along with the shapes. So let's say I duplicate this slide, and on this second slide I select this shape again, and now I again go to the shape format, edit shape, edit point, and now I will manipulate this shape. So let's say I want to move this point, but if you hold down and move this point, then you can see that it will add a curve to the between the points that I don't want. So what I can do, I can right click on this node, and I need to click on this corner point, even though it is selected, but I don't know why, but we still have to click this, and I will also do the same for this point as well. Now if I will move this point, then it will not add any curve unless I use these added points. So once you move to the desired location and edit the curves, the only thing that you need to do now is to add the morph transition. And after adding the morph transition, you can select the duration, that how much time you want the morph to happen between these two slides. So on the first slide I have not applied the morph. If you want to, you can also apply, but that will only work if you have added a loop between the slides. So let's say I have only added to the second slide the morph transition, and now if I move to the first slide and start the slideshow, you can also press the F5 key to start the slideshow from the beginning of the presentation. And if you want to start the slideshow from the current slide, then you can press Shift plus F5. So let's say I see the slideshow by pressing the F5 key, and now if I click this, I click on this slide to move to the next slide in the slideshow, then that is how it is going to animate, and that is how I have added the bends and curves in the character. So let me show you the character again. So let me delete this. So using the same technique, I have added the bends to this character, or potato character. So let's say we have this first slide with the complete character, and as the first pose of the animation. Now I will right click on this slide and will choose duplicate, and you can also notice the position of the shapes, that how I have placed a few shapes behind the other shapes. So after duplicating the slide, what I did, I just grab this shape and move it right here, and also make it rotate at some degree, and I do the same for the right side dumbbell, and also rotate it and adjust the position as required like this. And now I move this hand. You can see that how I have made the character and how the shapes has been drawn separately. And like this one, this body part, you can see this is a group shape, and the eyes are separate, and the nose and the legs are the separate shapes. So now I grab this hand here, zoom a little bit, and now I go to the shape format, edit shape, edit point, and now I will move this point right here, and this one as well. So it is up to you that how much curve or style that you want to add to your character. And I will do this the same for the right hand as well. Now I select the hand, go to shape format, edit shape, edit point. So as these shapes are already in curve, so I didn't use this corner point here, but I will use that option for the legs. Let me move down a bit. So here I want to make the legs straight. So I go to shape format, edit shape, edit point, and I right click on this point here and click on corner point, and do the same for this node as well. And now I can easily straighten this leg here, and I will do the same for the right leg. I am doing this to avoid the curve when straightening the legs. That's it. Now on the second slide, if you have seen earlier when I have shown you the outline view, that we also have these two ovals, hidden ovals. Let me show you by hiding all of the shapes and then just turning on these two. So you can see that you are still not seeing those two shapes, because those two shapes also have the same color as the background color, just to make them remain hidden. And why I did so, let me show you. On the second slide, you have seen that the character is closing his eyes. So what I did, I just moved these ovals on top of these eyes. Let me zoom in so I can place the shapes accurately. You can also make these ovals a little bit larger if you wanted to. And I will do the same for the right eye. All the shapes must be present on the slide. You can't add a new shape, otherwise the animation will not be so much accurate. I can increase the size if it is not covering the complete eye. I can increase the size, as the hidden eyes are having the same fill color, so the viewer will not notice that how we are doing this. And on the second slide, I have also changed the nose back to an oval shape by editing the points like this. And then I applied the morph transition with a duration of, let's say, half a second. So from the first slide, now if I will move to the second slide, you will see the animation that how it will happen. Let me set it on mouse click. So it doesn't move to the next slide until I click. So let's see the slideshow. And here we have the first slide, and now if I will click, then it will move all the shapes the way I have positioned them on the second slide with the morph transition. So that is how I have created this animation. And later what I did, I again duplicated the first slide and then placed it as third slide. Let me hide these ones by selecting all of them by holding the shift key and then right click and choose hide slide. So this slide will not appear in the slideshow. And now let me show you the slideshow again. You can also press F5 key to see the slideshow from the beginning. So this is our first slide, and this is the second slide, and this is the third slide. Let me increase the size of this hidden eye as well. You can hold down the Control, Alt and Shift keys while increasing the size of a shape. That way it will simultaneously increase from all the sides. So let me show you the slideshow once again. So I hope you will like this tutorial. And before ending this tutorial, let me tell you one more thing. Let me set the transition timing to 0.50 for all these three slides. You can select all of the slides and then can type the timing and press the enter key. And now I will make uncheck this on mouse click and make a check mark on after, and will not apply any timing. So that way after 0.50 second it will move to the second slide and then to the third slide, and then I will move to the slideshow because I want to see the animation in a loop. If I will not set this setting, setup slideshow, under the setup slideshow you can see that I have make a check mark on loop continuously until escape. So that way if I will run the slideshow now, then it will continue run in a loop. So I hope you will like this tutorial. There was a cockroach on my desk. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do share this video with your friends. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.